take off and land like this. Instead of the usual way, like this. But this airplane should fly like this, as fast and as economically as a conventional airplane. Many people have offered many solutions to the problem. V-STOLE era of aircraft with vertical rising, hovering, and high-speed flight capability moved closer to actuality early in 1964 as the Ryan Aeronautical Company unveiled the world's first lift-fan research aircraft, the XV-5A. This unique aircraft was designed and built by Ryan for the United States Army Transportation Research Command under contract to General Electric, developers of its lift-fan propulsion system. The XV-5A is supported by many years and several million man-hours of study and actual hardware experience by Ryan in developing revolutionary new vertical and short take-off and landing aircraft. Among the remarkable predecessors to the XV-5A was the world's first pure jet VTOL aircraft, the Ryan X-13 VertiJet, first flown in 1957. In 1955, Ryan engineers had begun work on a new concept, the fan-in-wing type airplane, VertiFan. And in 1957, Ryan was awarded an Air Force study contract to apply the VertiFan concept to military requirements. Instead of the larger, heavier, more powerful engines normally required for vertical flight, with their attendant weight penalty and higher fuel consumption in horizontal flight, the Ryan VertiFan design calls for power plants sized only for cruise and range requirements. To meet the power requirements of vertical takeoff, hovering, and landing, the basic thrust is multiplied 300% through fans installed in the wings and fuselage. The U.S. Army Transportation Research Command awarded General Electric and Ryan the contract to design and build two XV-5A research airplanes in 1961. Although studies directly associated with the aircraft were underway in 1959. More than 600 hours of wind tunnel tests with five different scale models, including 340 hours with a full-scale propulsion system, proved the effectiveness of the XV-5A's basic design. Flight operations from takeoff through transition were simulated at speeds from 0 to 120 knots, with lift fans operating up to full power. At the Ryan plant in San Diego, an XV-5A mock-up was built for engineering design confirmation and inspection. As fabrication of the two flight aircraft proceeded, interest was focused on the unusual fan-in-wing arrangement. This unique propulsion system consists of two GE J85 turbojet engines mounted high in the fuselage, two 5-foot diameter fans submerged in the wings, and a smaller fan in the nose just forward of the cockpit. By the use of diverter valves in the tailpipe, the thrust from the engines can be channeled to the fans for VTOL operation or out the tailpipe for conventional flight. The first of the two XV-5As was shipped by truck from San Diego to Edwards Air Force Base in February 1964. Within weeks, the second airplane was sent to the NASA Ames Research Center for wind tunnel testing. At Edwards, high-speed taxi tests were started in preparation for the first conventional flights soon to follow. But let's go back and examine the two decades of experience that led to these flights. Ryan's V-STOLE research actually began nearly a quarter century ago when the Army Air Corps sought a short-range observation plane for use from small, unprepared fields. Ryan's answer was the YO-51 Dragonfly, a two-place, single-engine, high-wing monoplane, which required less than 50 feet for takeoff and landing runs, and appeared almost to hover in certain conditions. Partly responsible was the tremendous area of the 52-foot wing, which had flaps so broad that they represented, in essence, a retractable wing. During World War II, Ryan produced the first tactical fighter for the Navy with a jet engine, a unique aircraft with a piston engine forward and a jet engine aft, the famed FR-1 Fireball. At a near-empty fuel condition, the Fireball's combined thrust was nearly equal to its weight. Ryan engineers began to realize that ultimately a jet propulsion system would be developed to produce thrust in excess of aircraft weight, making vertical takeoff possible. This led to informal studies of the possibilities of jet-powered V-STOL aircraft. In 1947, the Navy awarded Ryan a contract to explore the feasibility of reaction control for jet aircraft. A simple steel framework provided support for a conventional jet engine, a tailpipe, and the remainder of the jet reaction control system. On May 31, 1951, the lightly tethered rig made the world's first free hovering jet flight by remote control. The test vehicle took on the shape of an airplane, as a simulated delta wing was added and a crude cockpit was built atop the engine. In 1953, Ryan test pilot Pete Girard climbed aboard and made the world's first piloted hovering jet flight. The first X-13 Vertijet arrived at Edwards Air Force Flight Test Center in the fall of 1955. In more than 120 demonstration flights, the X-13 exhibited the precision and reliability of jet reaction controls and the Ryan-developed automatic stabilization system so successfully that one observer referred to this demonstration as the Vertijet Ballet. In a spectacular V-STOL concept, the deflected slipstream principle was studied by Ryan and successfully demonstrated by the VZ-3RY vertiplane. Built by Ryan for the Army and the Office of Naval Research in the late 1950s, the vertiplane uses large retractable flaps to deflect the propeller slipstream downward to provide vertical lift for takeoff, hovering, and landing. The flaps are retracted for conventional horizontal flight. Recently unveiled, the XC-142A Tilt Wing Transport is the world's largest vertical takeoff and landing aircraft. A three-company team effort, Ryan, Vought, and Hiller, the XC-142A is designed to carry 32 combat-ready troops or 8,000 pounds of cargo 200 to 300 miles at speeds up to 350 miles per hour. The wing can be tilted through an angle of 100 degrees, enabling the plane to tactical cargo aircraft being fabricated for operational evaluation, the first such military program to reach this status. For short field takeoff and landing requirements, Ryan has developed an entirely new family of aerial vehicles utilizing flexible materials for aerodynamic support. The Ryan Flex Wing was tested in a manned test bed using a membrane of flexible plastic-coated material attached to a keel and leading embers to form arrow or V-shaped wing surface, offering an extremely lightweight, large aerodynamic lift surface. This vehicle evolved into the XV-8A Fleet, a manned flying truck with a takeoff distance of less than 300 feet, a 1,000-pound payload capability, and a 100-mile range. Now flying at Edwards Air Force Base, setting the pace for world progress in V-STOL aircraft, is the XV-5A, the newest in a long line of such aircraft developed by Ryan. The XV-5A is the only aircraft in the world today that effectively blends the efficient lifting system of the helicopter with the high performance of the conventional jet. In little more than two decades, Ryan has accumulated over 3.5 million man-hours of V-STOL engineering development experience. This broad knowledge forms a backdrop as flight tests of the U.S. Army XB-5A move into high gear. The potentials of this remarkable new airplane appear as limitless as aviation's own future.